ano daw?
All troops deployed.
Sabi ni Alan Abita, yung sinabi ng pangalan ng member kakampi ko ay tut. Nasinoy,
isang mabilis, Louie on that Kaja, Gio on that Grok, Tang on that Thumbs, 666 on that Hayabusa.
For the side of our ancient ownage, we have Expert on this Dunox, Pimo for this Beleric, Lembot on this Kari, Pao for this Estes, and CKTD on this Cupra.
Yep. Pa-shoutout kay Mark Pascual at BJ Notarte, galing kay Joseph Patrick. Shoutout sa'yo.
Shoutout to you. Ayan daw, haya ni Boss Kenji, sabi ni Gresil Damandaman. Oh my gosh, I butchered her last name, I'm so
Gresil
sorry.
Gresil Damandaman?
Ay, hirap, I can't.
Mas ako ba yung nag-i-English stream dito kasi sa'yo, ba?
Anyway, also, early game, both teams are just securing the neutral creeps, the buff. You won't be seeing anything amazing unless we biglang mag-gank dito when they do reach level 4.
May nakita ko, may umiyak ka ba, Nomad? Hindi, may kumagat lang sa mata ko. Anyway.
Heartbroken si Nomad, guys. Hey. Oh, wala akong masabi.
Wala.
Suntukan na lang, ano?
Sampakin niyo rin! Ano ba?
Ang kasabi niyo masyado, nalimutan natin mag-cast na yun. Anyway,
reanimation
on the side of Archangel Onid. So, yung tatlong to yung hospital combo, bilang pumasok ni CKTD, pero kaya pa niya yung sustain yung damage na mga bounty ball lang dito. Pero pumasok, bigla sa kanya si Hayabusa, he's under threat to Kenji. Palag-palag, but wait, baka mong overextend. So, they just decided
to get away. Oh, wait, shit.
Nope.
Kala ko magre-ring of order siya. Pwede pa rin niya gawin
pwede yun. Pwede actually. Kasi parang half a bar na lang natin sa buhay ni CKTD doon.
Turtle is gonna be up. Either is in a good spot to take the Turtle, to be completely honest. Archangel Onage is making their way over to the bottom lane. So I think that's a good trade. Give away the Turtle for a secured bottom lane turret. That's more than you can ask for in the trade.
Mm-hmm. And do you think it's okay though? Turtle kapalit ng isang turret?
Yep. Malaki
or pa. Even lang.
Even siya, pero the damage buff that will be given to whoever nakalasit na hindi ko napansin.
Ayun yung makalasit ng turtle. Good.
Malaking bagay niya. I mean, look, pwede na i-trade nila kagad dito. Pero I think Archangel Onus is gonna try to go for a counter-initiate there, pero they don't have any initiation here. There goes a Divine Nature Shield V-Bot. And that is gonna be the first blood in the game. Archangel Onus is actually fighting back here. Lunox, Exhort, getting followed that.
Divine Nature Shield V-Bot, pero mukhang mapapatay na ang Lunox. That is a pretty much dead Lunox. Of course, kaya nasabi niya, hello. Pero nagamit na yung ultimate niya just enough to zone away the members from Archangel Onage.
That was a 1-for-3 trade with a third take. That's more than enough that Archangel Onage could ask for there. Actually, si Expert pala naka 3 kills zone. So they're funneling a lot of kills towards Lunox.
Which is something that we would expect given na pag early game carry is just gonna farm.
Exactly. Si Gary, magiging masakit na lang siya pagdating natin ng 8 minute mark. Mm-hmm. Soon as nag-endless battle siya going into... nalimut ko may binibuild. Endless battle going into a Demon on the Sword and then a Golden Staff, which is usually the build sometimes. Most of the times. Gio is kind of a...
Chill
lang dito.
Chill kasi, well, he is a tag. Medyo si Pimo parang na sinalo niya yung wave ni Kadita doon, pero he is tanky, so half a bar lang, tapos may regain din naman yung health niya. Walang problema. Shoutout naman dyan, Ariel Divina Gracia, Sang Sara Iloilo, Big Boss Me. Shoutout din daw kay na Monico Pileco, pero merong bumaksak na turret sa mid lane. That'll be another turret down, I guess, for the top lane kasi apat na members ng AAO nasa top lane. ML na ML sila, tapos yung other members ng Aether naman nasa bot lane.
ML na ML sila in terms of securing objectives, mga kaibigan. Di naman sila ML naghaharap ng laban kasi 5 minutes in the game, 4 kills pala nangyayari. This turtle though, it might go down quite easily, pero Archangel only, they're gonna opt to go for the objectives. Wow, the Tyrus Bane is gonna be committed there. Tank is gonna go down. Thanks to that turret aggro, the turtle is, I believe, is gonna go down. Thanks to Kadita, and Archangel Onage is sieging up this top lane turret. This is gonna be a huge problem for Aether.
Yep, they are opening their base, pero makakunti mo siya already. Oh, biglang nahila si Pimo, pero makakasurvive ba siya dito? I'm not sure, yes, nakakill sila, pero that isn't much given na yung dalawang damage dealer and yung tika-heal, yung healer ng AAO na buhay.
Yeah, and considering the fact na yung Archangel Onage, nakasecure sila ng dalawang turret dun sa push na yun. more than you can ever ask for.
Yeah, pero ang ganda na reflexes ni Lue doon ah, on Akaja, which oh nga pala, fleeting time already up for this Kaja. Next objective is gonna be up in 78 seconds, so chill-chill muna yung both teams. Ha, huh, sa tingin mo, medyo nagpabayaba yung Aether doon ng very, very slight. Kasi pansin ko, dire-diretso yung Archangel Onage kanina sa top lane.
Hindi, mas maganda yung rotation ng Archangel Onage kahit ang angulado. It's not that yung Aether pinabayaan nila laro. It's Archangel Onage being superior in terms of rotation. And we are seeing that they're singing as a four-man unit. I mean, it's gonna be given na si Bellrix sa si Essence magsasama yan kasama yung primary damage dealers nila dito na si Limbot sa si Exort kasi they need to make sure that they're alive as much as they can. Si KDD can just keep farming up, and I believe this is gonna be a fighter Kufra being built here in this game, so mamaya-maya pa siya magiging huge factor dito.
Tamang naka, pumasok, ginamit ng ultimate na din si Bellrix. He actually goes under there na Divine Judgment na mukhang patay na ngayon si Dima and Teng. Napakaganda positioning, pero he is actually receiving so much damage. Let the bodies hit the floor. Ang peg, Grok, wag ka nga alis. Meron ditong barrier. Pero he was able to dish out so much damage and mukhang triple kill going over to Kenji on this Hayabusa. Pero while everything is happening sa mid lane, akala ko mag-sweeper si KDD yung pala nag-release lang ng minion wave. Okay.
Tama rin isa.
Akala ko diretso na eh.
Kaya naman natin yun. It's a 1-for-4 trade and Aether is gonna be converting it into a turret push. Rightfully so, ang ganda ng take na yun. Turtle is gonna be the next objective as well. So they're maximizing their rotations and EXP and gold that they're gaining every time they switch from objective to objective. Tama lang naman ginawa nila eh. Archangel Onage though, they need to start pressuring the other lane so that they will not, para ma-alleviate yung pressure sa kanila.
Yeah.
Because right now, at this point in time, Aether Onage has the lead. 3,000 gold lead, a lead in terms of kills, pero they have the advantage in terms of the momentum that they're dictating here.
They do it then. Basically, kung titignan natin sa ML, yung momentum, yung pressure na kaya mong ibigay sa kalaban, that's what pretty much makes a team going eh. Sobrang yeah. Konyo nun. Pero yun, kasi parang alam nilang, feeling ko pag pumalag ako, kaya to. Yung gano'n, yung moral, kumbaga, ng team.
Kasi, sino ba nagsabi dun sa akin? Pag naglalaro ko ng specific heroes, like Thumbs, like Aldo,
okay.
Aljuice pala, sabi ni Madam Announcer.
Oh, sa ML, Aljuice daw.
Aljuice, hotdog ni Aljuice. Kailangan malakas loob mo pag
mag-finish ka. Hindi ko
malakas loob.
Ang dami niyang sinalo, pero tamang lifesteal lang. But Kanta and Bellrix actually use both of their ultimates ngayon. A-A-O! Lima sila dyan. Biglang pumalag, pero umalis muna ang Aether main. Tapos wait lang, nag-split push ang... Sabi ko, lasty, ang Grok na to sa bot lane, si J.O. pala.
Si J.O. ang nagsisplit push dito, but si KDD is gonna be there to respond. Doesn't even have to do anything here. Wala, Aether Onage is having a good foothold in this game.
Feeling ko Aether, kasi kanina ko pa Aether Onage ng Aether Onage.
Aether na lang, ayaw ko sabihin Atlas. Ano ba yun?
Niyon, bakit ganon?
Kasi kung EPL Onage lang yung pangalan nila, walang Archangel.
Pero tamang 1v1 muna dito sa bot lane. Pero of course, maghahampasa ng dalawang tanke na yan. Pero most members ng Archangel Onage is actually at the top lane. They are being clumped together 13 seconds before the next objective will spawn. Immortality up for Lue. So let's see, tiyan natin. Feeling ko maganda yung susunod na bakbakan eh.
POD onto Kenji. Masakit-sakit si Kenji nito dito.
Mahapdi.
Pagtingin
mo na ng itemization, nakamdam mo na yung damage, di ba?
Parang yung hapdi lang din sa mata ko ngayon. Ganun kasakit, mga
kaibigan. Nice one.
Sakit talaga eh.
Nakarelate mo pa yun.
Siyempre, kanina ko pa-relate na relate mo kung ano-ano dyan. Siyempre, ako rin naman. Siyempre, Lord.
This is level... What one, level 2? Level 1. Okay. So, kung sino naman ka-seeker niya, I guess they will be... But wait, nahila na naman po si Bimo, and will he actually survive this one? I don't think so. Megahead going over to this Hayabusa, and Dio nakapos siya ang sumasalo ng damage ni Kari at ni Lulox, pero nakaalis naman siya. Piling ko mambout na, pero si Kenji, gusto ko ng kill, kaya kong pamatay, pero sabi ng ibang members sa Aether, wait lang, pre, chill lang, dito muna tayo, rotate muna tayo, clean muna tayo ng waves.
Sa salita dapat ako naubo ako. Pero yung...
Galupit yung ano, mad na baubo si Nomad.
Yung Aether kasi, I like how their composition works around Lue having to go for the initiative. Wait, but hold that thought though. Si KDD is gonna jump in. They're gonna try to go for Kenji. Kenji pops the ultimate, but I don't think he'll be able to escape this unless he actually takes out Exhort before he goes down. He manages to survive. Kenji,
oh my god,
Hayabusa god.
Hayabusa god,
the MOBA legends here. knock up on the Bellerick. Not a lot of damage here on the side of Aether. They will be able to take down Arcane Onyx.
Pero Vivo, he's actually the only one left right there. Double kill going over the Vistamos. And that is another turn going over the side ng AE and Hakon. Lahat nangyayari sa top lane. 1v1 with the great one naman si Lembot dito kasama ang level 1 Lord. Si Dio sabi niya, hi, hello, nandito ako. Pero tamang barrier up muna habang Lloyd binawasak ang bot lane. Pero kill is free going over kay Cooper. But the shutdown naman ng Kalita ay napatay naman ni Duros ang Kalita na to.
Archangel Owen is just trying really hard to defend this push from coming from Aether. Yung nakita ko lang talaga dito si Lembot, ngayon lang siya nagkaroon ng golden staff, which is a
that's
huge
so
problem.
Late. That's
so late. Nakapag-endless battle siya, nag-golden staff na rin siya, natagalan siya dun, which is a problem.
Chill lang, nag-ano sila dyan eh. Bahala na sila dyan. May kanya-kanya usama sila dyan. Pero, 11 minutes in, gold advantage on the side ng Aether. Kill advantage, Aether then. Turret takedowns, Aether then. So I guess if Archangel Onyx does not do anything at this point, pero feeling ko kaya nila eh. They have the Lunox na ang ganda ng positioning kanina. May carry din siya na kayang kumatrat ng tank. They just need one or two good clashes if they really want to go to the epic comeback.
Pero si EDD has to make sure that the Tyrant's Rage is always on point kasi that's the only way that they can fight back here. Aether has a lot of initiates on their hand. I mean, not a lot per se, pero they got Kaja to pick off anybody. Geo's gonna be there to wall off anybody. Goes for the charge and it's gonna stop Archangel in their tracks. They also have Teng. Babato niya yung sights niya. Pagkabato ng sights niya, ibabalik lang niya. May mapupull kagad sa kanila. They also have the rough waves from Kadita na mananakap kung sino man. Kung marami sila na sa loob din sa rough waves, aangat yun at masakit yun. Which is a lot of possibilities for Aether to pull off. Na napupull off nila. Archangel Onyx, they're gonna be relying on CKDD to go for the Tyrant's Rage or for Beemo to go for the Roots.
So basically, parang kailangan ng magandang initiate ng Onyx for them to actually do something while sa side ng Aether. What do you think? Parang napaisip ka bigla. Deep in thought bigla. Do they need a good initiate or parang meron na silang mapatay? They're pretty much good to go.
I think mahirap kasi. Or you don't know kasi. Yeah, they can fight. They can fight if they want to fight. Pero
wala na yung chato. Kenji, go Kenji. Ang ganda nga ng play ni Kenji.
Pero yun nga, Archangel Onyx, if they want to keep fighting, they just need to make sure na hindi sila naglumalaban na 5-man versus 5-man. They need to pick somebody off on the side of the Aether. Sana si Kadita may pick off nila. Or si Kaja, malaking bagay din yun. And then try to force other misplays from Aether. That's the only way I can see Archangel Onyx from coming back here.
Basically it. Pero now, Aether is pretty much trying to lock Archangel Onyx down sa kanilang sarili lang base. Again, this is game 2. Aether up on one game. So, pag nanalo sila dito, 2-0, Matip, champion na sila.
Champion na sila. Mananalo na lang AED pa kami ng shoutouts. Pa-shoutout, Changgu and friends. Okay. Shoutout sa inyo.
Shoutout dyan.
They're gonna be starting on the Lord here.
This is a level 2 Lord, so more tanky than the level 1 Lord. Aether is probably gonna secure this non-contested at all kasi ang layo ng ibang members ng Archangel Onyx. That is more pressure going on to the side ng Aether.
Yeah, and Geo doing a good job just zoning out Archangel Onyx there.
Alright, so I guess nakikita naman natin, medyo nalilimitahan na yung galawan ng Archangel Onyx. Like, they can't push the way they want to. Do you think they could have improved on their draft?
I mean, they tried to make the SS Bellerick work. But just like what we were talking about during the late game with Wolf, the problem that inherently Onyx has here is that they're being coached by Coach Panda as well.
Mm-hmm.
But the thing is, whatever draft that Coach Panda makes up for Archangel Onyx, sometimes they won't be able to execute it properly. They have an understanding of how to play the heroes, but they don't have an understanding of how to play the composition. This Bellerick and SS composition is going to rely heavily on them making sure that Lembot stays alive. Pero Aether, they have means to just close in onto Lembot.
Tsaka napapasin ko, lagi nasa stun or natatarget down si Pau. So he's not able to sustain Lembot or even Exort. So micro plays from Aether, it really works for them.
Si
Didi next target dito. Na stun, nahila, lahat na lang ata sinalong. Pero of course, tumapalag na ngayon ang Archangel Onyx. Hello, sabi ni Lunox. Pero na-burst siya, napakasakit naman ng pagbabasa ni Kadita doon. Tiyanggo ng Malakas, sabi ni Maria Angelica Arimado.
I mean, it's a good thing that they were able to pop the immortality there, pero to what extent Aether is still sieging up really good here against Onich?
Medyo, parang nakamdaman ko medyo nagiging careful na yung hindi. Kung kanina, parang ML na ML sila, G na G ngayon, they're waiting for the proper time to actually end the game. Kasi, isa na lang eh. Isang magandang play or isang maling play, that will pretty much determine kung sino ang champion dito.
Objective na yung Aether ngayon. Hindi na sila ML na mag-arap ng kills.
Pero di ba, ever since naman okay naman yung galawan ng Aether, gabi ka naman.
Oh, ganun talaga. Let's see, Ardino Onion is still trying to defend this as much as possible. Shield's gonna be on top there. That's
Alright, here we go. Tamang hover dito muna sa mid lane. Nako po! Estes actually going down sa kamay ni Kadida. That is one member down for the side of Archangel. Medyo hindi maganda yung naging positioning ni Estes doon. Ito na yung momentum. Ito na yan, pre. This is it, fancy. Hayabusa sa Lord Genji daw, sabi ni Amir Babaran. Amir pala. I'm so sorry.
The turret is gonna go down. It's actually gonna manage to survive, but the minion waves are gonna be making their way over to the bottom lane.
Broken Cooper though, parang may sarili silang mundo doon, parang naghahampa sa yung dalawang tanke, but they're both tanks, so I don't think they won't be able to kill anyone there, but yung damage dealers, here in the mid and bot lane, Immortality already up for Kairi, so in waiting game talaga eh.
Yeah,
kung may mahuli, doon lang papalag. Kung wala, ikot-ikot lang.
Smart call by Archangel Onich to go for the pushes here, pero there is going to be a fast rotation from Aether. Hindi makapush yung Archangel Onich. I mean, they're able to shove out the lanes. You can give them that, pero they need to start securing objectives here, which is going to be the level, the third lord of the game, about to spawn in about 30 seconds. Archangel Onich trying to find a good foothold in this match. They do spot out Geo. I don't think it's going to be worth their time to chase down Geo, because all of their other lanes can be pushed out, and that's what Geo can just do here.
But nag-commit na sila, so they're already there. Might as well kill this guy. Carry able to take down this Grox. So one kill going over sa side ng Archangel Onich, but Kaja and this Kalita pushing here at the mid lane.
Teka lang, may nalilito sa chat eh. No, in Season 3, Onich and Archangel are two different, they're two completely different teams. And this is a completely different team. This is Onich nung MPL Season 3. Bawal lang kasi magkaroon ng dalawang Archangel. Kumbaga.
Sabi ni Sha dito, wag na away, support lang. Oo naman, tama siya. Support lang. Kung kasi, gusto nyo magpag-away, suntukan na lang kayo after ng live stream. Pero ngayon, support your favorite
kasi team. Kasi yung mga teams na to, magtatropa din sa outside the game eh. Kung kayo nag-away, paano pa yung teams nyo, di ba? Na hindi nag-away.
Oh, chill lang. Pero here we could see Archangel Onich eyeing this objective. A very important objective this time around. Pero napakagaling ng positioning ni Lembo. Dito tamang bato-bato lang ng damage. Sinalo lahat ni Kenji Luwe though. Down to the last two bars of his health.
Yung sinasabi ko, Archangel Onich will have the upper hand pag hindi 5v5 ilaban. Kailangan may disadvantage dito sa labanan. Pero while that's happening, Kenji is actually gonna try to split push over the top lane. They're trying to bait out an engagement here against the Lord. Wala pa si Kaja sa usapan. Ang pinauwi nila. Pero mamaya-maya nandito na siya. They're really sorting a lot of effort here towards the Lord, and it's going to be a matter of time to determine who's going to go for it. Kaneda's going to go for the rough waves. The Lord is going to be secured by Aether. This is going to be a hard time, and they are making a good choice to just disengage right now.
Of course, hinahaba na lang ngayon si Grok. Will they be able to actually get away with it? Luwe, napakadaming damage ang sinasalo. Immortality has been popped and immobilized na ngayon si Teng. But that is pretty much enough for Lunox and kay Belleric. They're just gonna back away.
Yeah, tama, backup nandito. They need to defend this Lord push. They need to stop the Lord push from happening in the bottom lane. Lalo na yung Lord push, mga tatlo, apat na hampas, quarter HP kagad din sa base.
Sakit ni CKTD.
And they are going to focus all of their attention there onto the Lord. And it's just gonna be up to Belleric and CKTD. Belleric and Kufra to defend this. I don't think they would be able to defend this.
I don't think so as well. But I guess here, Bimo forced to stay outside ng 30.
Oh!
Na hila, na stun. Pero ginamit niya ultimate na immobilize and speed up. Pero I don't think like anymore si Teng, kasi si CKTD is right there at the top lane. He was able to get away. The Lemon says hello, nagpato na naman ng damage, but Grox Barry actually got up.
Item check though, sa ang mabilisang item check.
Ayan.
Lock items na po sila mga kaibigan. Sige.
Ang ganda tignan ng ganyan eh, no?
Ganda tignan ng ganyan. Lock items na. Pero but sana kasi kung pare-pares yung lahat ng blue nandito, lahat ng red para mas
maalis. Na-trigger yung OCD mo?
Yes. Yes.
Nice one. What if, no, yung may mga teams ganun, kapag, uy, blue item na kami, kayo. So then, sige, para pag nag-item check, rainbow.
Sana kung maayos ang ito. Pero that's not
gonna happen. That's not gonna happen. It's a nice thought.
Focus lang sila sa laro. Tamang focus lang. Focus.
Focus with a capital P, pero Onage still able to defend their base. Again, isang magandang clash or isang masamang clash, yun na yung magdedetermine kung sino ang panalo. Kasi if ever manalo yung Onage, pwede silang rumekta sa top lane. But if either naman, rekta mid lane sila.
Pero, yun nga. Just...
Wow, promoting suntukan. Good job, Ate Girl. Ate Girl, I was being sarcastic.
You don't... I mean, yeah. Since that... Kasi yung mga jokes ni Yuko...
Kasi stress ka na, no? What, eh, no?
Kasi yung jokes ni Yuko, hindi ko magana, guys. Yan na natin realize.
Mama mo, hindi ko magana. So, okay. So, lang. Anyway, going back into the game.
Anyway, sige. Back into the game na tayo dito. Archangel Onage.
Ano, may ako sa Archangel Onage.
Mahumala. Bahala ka dyan. Archangel Onage. All their wala na sila turret, yun na yun.
They do not have any turrets left. Well, na-translate ka na.
Nawawala na ng English.
Where is your English?
Naubos na nung MPL eh.
So bagay, full English stream ka kasi
na. Full English ako na, wala akong Tagalog
yeah.
Sa sistema na. Pero, yun nga, it's only gonna be a matter of time here before Aether actually tries to scare the fourth lord of the game, which is gonna be up in about 50 seconds.
Do you think naghihintay lang yung Aether dito or nahihirapan silang i-end yung game? Kasi diba, may teams na they're just waiting for the proper time to close the game, pero may teams na hindi nila masarado yung game.
Nag-iingat kasi yung Aether ngayon, kasi at this point in the game, ang taas na ng death timer sila. And sa 40-50 seconds natin yung death timer at this point, na malaking halaga yun kasi mabilis na mawala yung matutunaw yung turret. So Aether wants to play it safe. They don't want to give away any easy kills.
Mm-hmm.
Kasi yun nga, yung Archangel Onage may advantage sila pag pumasok sila sa 5v4 na laban, 5v3 na laban, kasi yung may advantage. So, kung mapipilit ng Archangel Onage mag-misplay yung Aether, they will have a chance to force a game 3 here. Pero the thing is, Tams is split pushing in the bottom lane, shoving out the minion wave towards the base, and it's gonna be applying a lot of pressure. With that being said, the pressure that's being added towards the lanes, Aether's gonna be capitalize on the fact that, hey, basically sila mag-defend the lane, kukunin natin yung Lord dito.
Mm-hmm. But nakita yun ng Archangel Onage, so they will try to at least take someone down or at least steal yung objective na to. Beleric actually used his ultimate yet again. Estes, of course, tamang sustain lang. But Lembot actually had his eyes on Tank, pero naka-alis siya. 666 actually gonna get away kasi last two bars of his health, medyo maganda yung galawan ni Lembot dun. Masakit na, of course, si Gary, kasi late game eh.
Not just late game, we are in the hyper late game stage of the game. 23 minutes na tayo, mga kaibigan. Yeah, Archangel Onage is gonna start with the Lord, but I don't think they should be starting with the Lord. Kasi may retribution si Hayabusa, kaya niya mag-steal niyan. At the same time, si Karita, pwede siya mag-ult, papasok, at mababurst out yung Lord. And I think this is gonna be an initiate.
Wow.
This is gonna be the initiate. That's what is gonna be determining who's gonna take game number 2 or gonna be seeing game number 3. Archangel Onage is looking really healthy at this point in time. Immortality is gonna be popped there onto the side of Thams. Thams is finally down. If anything, this is a pristine opportunity for Archangel Onage to try to secure the Lord while CKDD is going for the fight. Pero 4v4 sila dito, they need CKDD badly. But CKDD needs to defend the base as
yeah,
well.
Yeah, maiwan mo na si Kufer doon to make sure na walang minions yung mag-shove in on their base. Kenji jumps in, jumps out. Will AAO be able to secure this level 3, level 4 Lord though?
Yeah, this level 4 Lord is going to be hard to take down. And Aether Onage is going to try to go for the steal. Katita is in position here. He's going to go and pop the ultimate. The rough wave as well. It's going to be there.
Secured.
The Lord is going to be secured by Onage. But at this point in time, Archangel Onage is coming out on top. Dewey is gonna go down as well as Katita. I think 6-6 is no longer in the fight here. 40 seconds spawn timer. This is sabi ko, ang taas ng respawn timer nila.
Yep, that's true. That was a 3-4 trade in favor of Archangel. I guess they could go with another push. They do have the minions. Athena Shield already up for Estes. That was a beautiful clash for Archangel Onyx.
That was a beautiful clash, pero the thing is, CADD is forced to be left behind here para ma-defend. That was a quick turn, takedown here. Nice wall by Grock to stop the push from coming in from Archangel Onyx, but the turns are still there. The cannon, the yung mga clash gear, nandiyan sila para and now it's gonna be Super Minions in the mid lane. Level Warlord is coming from the top side, so if anything, Archangel Onyx needs to start shoving the bottom lane as well, alleviate some pressure from CKDD so he can rejoin the fight. Kasi malaking bagay din yung Tyrant Stage, malaking bagay yung bouncing ball dito against this composition that Aether has.
Pero feeling ko, hindi ko rin masisa yung Archangel Onyx if hindi nila maiwan na bear yung base. Kasi that's literally, base na lang yun nandyan. Mas fit po siya lang sila. Bye-bye.
Good job on Thams to cut off the minion wave from pushing in the mid lane. Malaking bagay yan. Sobrang laking bagay niya para sa kanila. It's gonna be alleviating a hell of a lot of pressure sa mid lane. But while that's happening, nice wall up onto the Lord.
Uh-huh.
Gonna go ahead and charge towards the top lane. Archangel Onyx is hanging on here. Kenji kind of overstaying his welcome. He's gonna be forced to shadow out there. No minions at all here. Bottom lane's gonna be pushed by CKDD, but look at the damage double being expressed here by Aether. Grock is gonna be able to take down SS, and this is not a good spot for Archangel Onyx. They were overstaying their welcome. All the immortalities are being popped. CKDD is joining the fight, but he doesn't have enough damage there. But he was actually able to take down Hayabusa. Lambot needs to run away here from Jo because Jo is still gonna hurt a lot against Lambot, and they still need to start running away.
Launch attack now since kaya nilang pumalago, but Kaja, wait, four members actually up on the side of Aether while dalawa na lang side ng Archangel.
Oh, CKDD is actually gonna jump in. He's dealing a lot of damage on the 666, but he's gonna be forced back here.
Kaya ako natatakot pa kay CKDD. Anyway, if he thinks he can give it a go, then why not, diba? Better na yung makapagda siya ng pressure here at the mid lane just so na hindi maka-advance yung Aether.
I think this is the longest game that we've ever had in the mobile esports arena.
Yep. Mag-30 minutes na.
30 minutes. This feels like an MPL game.
Yes, it does. Well, pro teams naman yung pakiyo.
Pro teams
kasi,
yun nga. They already faced off against each other.
A lot of times. Man, baka kanina it was leaning towards an Archangel Onyx game, pero nung nasa top lane sila, biglang pumalag yung Aether.
Malapit na tayo mag
100k sa side na Aether, oh.
Wala, ipento niya lahat ng gamit niyo, sa to wala kayo na walang gamit. Yun na lang gawin niyo. Para magkaalaman na.
Why not, di ba? And mayroon nagsasabi, segue daw dapat. May nagsasabi, 2-0 daw. Tapos may nagsabi na wala daw MM sa AE. Let's see.
Kahit kami, di namin mapredict kung ano nangyari. Kasi ang ganda ng hold na ginawa ng Archangel dito. I mean, look at the scoreboard. 15-15. Halos even na rin sila in terms of pushes. Lahat ng lanes, maliban sa bottom lane, panay super minions na.
Match point din kasi for AE, and of course ito yung last game of hope ng Archangel Onyx for if they want to push with a game 3 Lambot. Actually nagsakitan ng damage dyan, bakit nakita mo yun?
They're going to try to siege this up, and I think it's gonna be a matter of time before Archangel Onyx would be able to wipe this out. Pero Aether, they still have a good chance here. They just need to make sure that they time their initiates correctly here. They need to pick off the correct person as well. Nature Shield is going to be popped here over to the mid lane. Not a good spot for Aether, to be completely honest. Here are Matt. They do manage to pop off two immortalities here. Grock is down 1 minute out of the equation as well as Thams. It's only going to be a matter of time before Archangel forces this into a game number 3. Kenji going to do what he can to try to defend this, but it's not going to happen. Whoa, actually, Kenji will be able to kill one. Gets a double kill onto Bebo. Defending this with the minion waves are still going to be too strong.
Na defend pa ni Kenji on that is really amazing. Pero first do it, medyo masakit nga pero Kenji, he's still gonna give it a go.
He's
behind judgment kay Lunox, pero apparently this